Alright, Puggsy, we know you're in there. Come out with your hands up. We are going back to Rack Rock Forge because I said that the Aztec Games was the last secret level in the game, and that was a lie. My pants are currently on fire. Well, okay, it wasn't a lie. I was just mistaken. There's one more mini game that we can get, and it's not really very good, but we have to get it anyway, just for the sake of completeness. Let's see how long it takes me to do this time. I'm gonna jump. Damn it. Little frame skip never hurt anybody. I'm using the power of computers to help cheat. Well, that's not cheating. Alright, and there are two other orbs here, and if we really wanted to, we could turn these all into hearts and get three extra lives on this level, but that's not worth it at all. Alright, when we go out that exit, that opens up Pugsanoid. This is really a crappy little minigame. Okay, we have an extra life, and okay, the four holes there, when you go in them, they hurt. They lead to death. So I'm going to do this the slow, boring way. And if we drop the heart down there, then we lose it, and we have to start the level over. Pugsanoid is based on Arkanoid, which is a famous breakout-like game. It's not really based on it. It's just that's where the name came from. Oh, would you look at that? Come on, Pugsy, get up there, get up there. Okay, as somebody pointed out, there is a pair of speed shoes on Fireheart that I could have gotten, and it would have saved me from having to go back a bunch of times. It's not this level. And, like a dummy, I didn't see it at all. So, thanks, anonymous benefactor. Okay, let's take on the boss level of Rack Rock Forge. I don't remember much about this level, except that there are bears jumping around everywhere trying to hurt me. A balloon and a key. Oh, I remember. Okay, first things first, let's take care of these bears. We are at BearCon 3, ladies and gentlemen. As we all know, bears are ruthless killing machines. Okay, I remember that if we flip that switch, then we fall down into an inescapable pit, and we have to start the level over. So let's try not to flip that switch. Okay, let's take this key and set it on this balloon. And we're going to send that key on a magical journey. Magical journey to Sky World. Or to the top of the shaft. Godspeed, key. Godspeed. Alright, and let's see if we can get this key without dying. And we can. Alright, get ready to defeat the lamest boss in the game. It's not really a boss, as much as it is an FMV sequence. I know they just did this so they had an excuse to add another FMV sequence. The game's fine without them. I mean, really, the Genesis version is just as good as any other version. Hey, what happened to my speed shoes? Lazy programmers. You don't really defeat this boss as much as you avoid him. To win, all you have to do is not get hurt.
Oh, excuse me.
This boss really doesn't make any sense. It doesn't really tie in with the theme of Rock Rock Forge. The other bosses at least have something to do with the theme of the level they're on. And it just dies and falls into the water for no reason. Lamest boss ever. Huh? That was the last boss, wasn't it? Is the game over? Did we beat it? Let's see what the cutscene has to say. Our ship is... looks like some sort of throne, maybe? A royal antechamber? I don't know. I don't bother trying to understand this stuff. I just enjoy the game. Okay, the Reclantis docks. Actually, there might be one more area after this, so Rock Rock Forge isn't the next to last area. Go easy on me. It's been years since I played this. Some pretty nifty original music here. The exit is straight down from here. I forget what we have to do. Okay, we had to make it over to this side. And then we take this match. And I think we have to jump back across. Well, we can only jump back across because we have the shoes. If we didn't have the shoes, we'd have to go the top way. Light this cannon. And, oh, we were supposed to catch that ball. Damn it. Take two. Let's take something just in case we don't make the jump. I'm sure we will, but I like to play it safe. Okay, instead of lighting it directly, we have to toss it at the cannon. Then grab that. We can't jump across with the bowling ball because its weight will drag us down and it won't be very pleasant. So we have to go the top way again. Take the high road. And with this bowling ball, we can use its weight to make it past this fan. And the exit should be somewhere around here. There it is. Alright, that about does it for this episode. Tune in next time for more Reclantis Docks. See you later.